Good morning, childrens. Myself, Lakshman Suryavanshi from Diamond High School, Balki. Today, I am going to take the topic related to the social science for the 10th standard. So, we know that social science gives us a knowledge related to the point of society and the point of science also. So, among that, in the social science, we are going to study about the related points. There are some subparts we are going to study in this topic. So, those subparts are history, political science, sociology, geography, economics, and the business study. Business study. So, in the every part, we are going to study about the some different points. So, you can take the example of history. We are going to study in the history about the past events related to the any country or any historical places or any persons. Come to the point of political science. In the political science, we are going to study about the political or the politics or the political things. We are going to study about the particular countries or the particular point of views. In the sociology, we are going to study the point related to the society. What kind of society developed, how the society was developed, all those things we are going to study in the society, sociology. Next point is geography. In geography, we are going to get the knowledge related to the point of land resource earth or the source of earth. Then in the economics, we are going to study the economic status of the country, economic status of the particular business persons, or economics point related to the world. All these topics we are going to study in the economics. So then the last part one, that is business study. So in the business study, we are going to study about the points related to the business. You can take the example of many types of business we are going to study in the country level. So in that business study, we are going to study about the money or credit. So these type of points we are going to study in the business study. Now today I am going to take the topic related to the history, the part of 10th standard. So among this, the part of 10th standard, today I am going to take the topic related to the history, the first unit first, that is advent of Europeans to India. Advent of Europeans to India. So this advent of Europeans to India, in this topic we are going to study the point related, or we are going to learn the point related to the. So the first point is the trade and the commerce relationship India had with the Europeans. And the second point, the arrival of Europeans to India for the trade. Third point, the Carnatic Wars in the backdrop of European political developments. Then fourth point is the point related to the Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar, and the dual government system. And the fifth point is the British policy of aggression. So these are the points we are going to learn in the history of this first unit, advent of Europeans to India. So children, see here, what is the meaning of advent? Advent means the arrival. So why the people of Europeans arrival toward the India, that we are going to study in this topic. Among that, today I want to discuss the two topics related to this chapter, that is the trade and commerce relations had with the India by the Europeans, and the arrival of Europeans to India for the trade. Okay. So student, first in this topic we are going to study the point related to the trade and commerce relations with the Europeans and the India. So the trade and commerce relations between India and the Europe is very ancient. It means since from the ancient period we are finding the relations with the India or the Asian countries by the Europeans. So why these people are maintained the relation towards India, toward the Asian continent for the trade and the commerce? Because that time we are going to see these areas or the ancient since from the ancient side, we are finding the eastern countries. From the eastern side, they are getting the lot of benefit due to the demand. There was a great demand for the spices in Europe, like pepper, cardamom, ginger, and clove. And these type of products, these type of spices, the Europeans were finding from the eastern countries or the Asian countries. From that, India is having the lot of production of pepper, cardamom, ginger, and the clove. So that time, the first, we know in the history, in the ancient, since from the ancient time, we are finding the first trade they have developed with the India by the Marco Polo and his brother. So this Marco Polo has started the business with India in the ancient period. Since from that, we are going to see the relation was developed in India in the Middle Ages also. So that time, they have given the more importance to the paper, cardamom, ginger, and the clove. So why these Europeans were giving the more importance to the paper, cardamom, and the ginger, and the clove? Because these type of spices are developing the heat in the body of the woman. And we know the climate of Europeans, and we know the climate of Eastern countries. So when we are getting the temperature of 29 in the our side, that time, we are going to find the temperature toward the America, toward the England, towards the European country. There we are finding only the 12% to 13% of the temperature. So due to the low temperature, these people are needed more spicy things. So those spicy things they are going to see in the eastern part of the world. So that's why they have given the more importance to the paper, cardamom, ginger, and the clove. So that was the main part we are going to see in the history of Europeans who made the advent toward the India at their travel to maintain the trade relations with the India. So next point, from how, from where they are getting the these type of spices. So that time we are going to see the one of the important place they have maintained, or the marketing place they have chosen that time, that is Constantinople was the center of European trade. It becomes the gateway of Europeans to take the spices toward the Europe from the eastern countries. So where it is, the Constantinople was the one of the place we are going to see in the Turk, or you can say that the Arab countries. So these Arab countries have developed one of the marketing place by the name Constantinople. So now the Constantinople become the center place for the trade for the European from India. And these Indian goods were going toward the Constantinople, and these Arabians or the Turks people or the Ottoman Turks people, they are selling these goods to the Italy. Which place? So Italian sailors, they are going to take the goods from the Constantinople, and they have started to sell these goods in the European countries. So now there was a business we are going to see in between the Italy and the Arab countries by maintaining the center place, that is the Constantinople. Okay boys, so Constantinople become the center place. So by maintaining this, they have made the business in the Middle Ages. But what happened? These Arab merchants got a monopoly over toward the Indian goods. One side, we are going to see, one side, Arab merchants were getting the monopoly over the Asian trade. And one side, we are finding the Italy had the monopoly over the European trade. It means the Arab merchants are selling the goods in the Asian continent. So they have developed the Eurasian trade relations. And one side, we are finding the Italy maintained the monopoly over the European trades. So two sides we are finding the, and they have kept the Constantinople as the center place for the marketing or developing the trade relations with the Europeans. So by this way, we are going to see the Constantinople become the famous marketing place for the both Europeans and the Asians, or we can say both the Arab merchants and the Italy merchants. But due to some problems, or due to the some problems, there was a question arises, the fall of Constantinople. It means the fall of Constantinople means there was the problem arises in the Arab merchants and the Italian merchants. What are the problems they are going to find in between the Asian merchants and the Arab merchants and the Italian merchants? So the first main problem we are going to see, the Asia and Europe trade was taking place through the Constantinople. So the first point is, already we have studied in the last topic, that Constantinople was the center place for the Asia and the Europe. So it became a very different problem for the these merchants belongs to the Arab country and the merchants belong to the Italy. So what is the problem by the center of Constantinople is, this place was the point of Arabian countries. Now, it was captured by the Ottoman Turks in the 1453 and control over it. So due to the marketing center point, that time in 1453, we are going to see when the Ottoman Turks got some different knowledge of benefit related to the this trade or the these monopoly goods. They have captured the place, the center place, and they have taken the control over toward the this Constantinople. Now it becomes a problem towards the Italy people. So Turk started to levy more taxes on goods passed through. So after getting the capture towards the Constantinople, now the Turks, who belongs to the Arabs, now they got an important aim among that. We have to take the more taxes. Levy means now they have started to put the more taxes, sending the goods toward the Italy. So earlier Italy was getting more benefit from these goods. Now due to the levy of heavy taxes, due to the keeping of heavy taxes, now Italy was getting lot of problems to sell the goods in the Europe. So that is the main problem arises among the Italy and the Turks. Now that time these traders belongs to the Italy. Traders felt trade is not profitable and stopped. Now due to the levy of heavy taxes by the Turks, now the Italy people are getting no profit from the selling of these goods in the European countries. So that time the traders belongs to the Italy, they are not finding any kind of profit from the selling of goods. So they have stopped their business from the this Constantinople. The fourth point is, Spain and Portugal encouraged sailing to reach route to the India. So after getting the close of route from the Constantinople, now this Spain and the Portugal, they want to get the new route toward the India. But that time it was a very difficult point.
are a difficult task to reach to the India by the land route, because already Turk has captured this important place by the name Constantinople. Now, Spain and Portugal encouraged sailing to reach by searching a new place or searching a new route to India to develop the relations with the India. So that time the Italians, the Spain people, the Portugal people, they have started give some important things which are related to search the sea route to the India. So they have invented many types of instruments to supply the sailors of Italy, that is compass, astrolabe, gunpowder and some maps to get the other route to the these sailors to find out the sea route to India. So these type of new things, this type of new inventions were made by the Europeans or the sailors from the Spain and the Portugal, and they have started to get the searching of new route toward the India. Okay, children, we have studied the point related to the search of new sea route to the India by the European sailors. How they have started to search the new sea route to the India. So I will show the map related to the how the people of Europeans, they have came towards, or they have reached towards the India by the Europe side. So you can take the example of one of the important person who visited to India first time in 1498. The person by the name, you know, already we have studied in the last classes, by the name Vasco da Gama. So after getting the problem in the 1453 by the place of Constantinople, the people belongs to the Portuguese, or the sailors belongs to the European country, they have started to develop the new route to India. So they have started to search the route from the European side by the sea route. So first this Portuguese sailor started a search of new sea route from the Lisbon, and he visited by searching the place toward the India by the sea route. He has started his journey from the Lisbon, that comes in the Portuguese. So by the Lisbon, he reached to the Vasco da Gama, has reached toward the Cape of Verde Island. And after reaching toward the place of Verde Island, he started to continue his journey. And after continuing his journey, he reached toward the Cape of Good Hope. So this place becomes the important point to the these sailors, because this place become the center point to go towards or to search the route toward the India. Now Vasco da Gama has reached towards the Cape of the Good Hope. After reaching this place, he has continued the searching of route. He has continued journey, and here we are going to see the important place, that is the Natal, which is coming in the South Africa. So he reached toward the Natal and continued his journey, and lastly we know that also coming in the South Africa, he reached the place of Malindi. After getting the reach of Malindi, now it was the nearest place to the this Vasco da Gama to go toward the India. So with the help of map, we know that already we have studied the many instruments were developed by the Europeans to search the route. So with the help of map, when he reached to the place of Malindi, he started to get the journey toward the India. So when he had started the journey, he reached the important place, or the he reached toward the India in the year of 1498, that to the date of 1498. So on this day, Vasco da Gama has reached to the place by the name Calicut, or Calicut, that is comes in the Kerala. This is the place coming in the state of Kerala. So the main place in this Calicut, there we are finding the one of the village name by the name Kozhikode. Kozhikode was the Kozhikode. It is the village there the Vasco da Gama has first reached in the 1498. And after reaching this place, so many types of changes we are going to find in the history of the Portuguese. So now we can say that the first person, or the first person who reached by the sea route toward the India in the 1498 was the first person by the name Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama. So he became the important person to reach the India. So many times we are going to see, or we are going to hear, many people have searched the route. Many people have made a work to search the route toward the India, but they are unsuccessful, and this Vasco da Gama has become the successful person to reach Kozhikode, or the Kozhikode in the Calicut, that is the coming in the Kerala state by these routes. So many people have visited. They came toward the Cape of Verde Island. They came toward the Cape of Good Hope. They reached toward the Natal. They have reached toward the Nalindi, but they may not be able to reach the place Kozhikode. So Vasco da Gama became the important person to reach the Kozhikode place in Kerala. Okay, now we have learned that in 1498, this Vasco da Gama has made a successful journey to visit the India. But after the visit, we are going to see many companies from the European countries, many companies from the European companies, they have started to visit toward the India for the development of trade and the commerce relations in the India. So now we can come to the point of companies visited to India. Companies visited to India for the purpose of trade development from the Europe. So now after the knowing of the route, now many companies, they got ideas how to reach toward the India. So that time, after the Vasco da Gama, we are going to see the many people from the European countries have started to visit toward the India. So which type of companies, or the what type of companies has reached to the India? There are some important companies, or the important places we are going to see which have visited toward the India. So we know that the first place is Portuguese. The first company is Portuguese, which is visited first time toward the India for the trade development. And second one is, we know that Dutch. Dutch is the second company which has visited toward the India for the development of trade. And the third one we are going to see, third one is the Danish. That we can say that Denmark. Denmark. So this was the third company which was visited for the trade development in India from the Europe side. And the fourth one is, that is, we know very well, we have ruled for the 200 years for India. That is English, or we can say the English. We can say Britain. So these people have ruled for India. We know already, we are going to study many times in the history of India. They have ruled for the 200 years. So these people become the fourth to visit India for the development of trade. And the last important one, that is French. So French become the fifth position to came toward the India for the development of trade. So children, we are going to see the five places, the five important companies which have visited to India to develop the business, or to develop the trade, to develop the commerce relations with the India. So among that, we are going to learn the first important company, that is Portuguese, which have started first journey toward the India for the development of trade. So the first company which was started his business, started his trade relations toward the India by the Portuguese. So this company which was started in the 1798, that time, you know that one of the person by the name Vasco da Gama, who reached toward the Calicut, and he has shown the way to the Europe. He has shown the way to the Portuguese to go toward the India and develop the trade relations. Now, the Portuguese who came to India on 1798 at Calicut, that under the famous person by the name Vasco da Gama, and he reached the Kozhikeda. Already I told you, in present it coming in the Kerala state. So that time when he reached to the Kerala, the person who was ruling this Calicut place was by the name Jumurin. So Jumurin was the one of the person who was ruling toward the Calicut now. So that time the Vasco da Gama has reached, and he has given the ideas to the Portuguese people to go towards India for the purpose of getting the trade relations. So we know that in the history, we are going to see after the Vasco da Gama, or the Vasco da Gama, the next person from the Portuguese side, we are going to see who visited to India was Francisco Almeida as a viceroy of India. So Almeida, Francisco Almeida, who reached after the Vasco da Gama towards India as a viceroy. So after visiting this Francisco Almeida as a viceroy of India, he has started many developments in India for the development of trade. So earlier, Vasco da Gama has not done any kind of development for the trade purpose. He was not a person who visited to India to develop the trade. But the next person who came from the Portuguese side, he visited to India with the aim of the development of a trade relations with India. So that time he came with the post of viceroy. And after reaching to the India, he implemented a new policy. Many types of policies were implemented by the Francisco Almeida, but among that, the first important policy we are going to see developed by this Almeida was blue water policy. So what is the meaning of blue water policy, which was developed by the Francisco Almeida? Was that time he want to show the supremacy toward the water, or supremacy toward the water bodies. So that time he has given the blue water policy new idea. So he want to show the supremacy toward this area, and he want to become the boss to this route. So that was a new implementation made by the Francisco Almeida, who reached after the Vasco da Gama. But when Almeida has implemented this policy, after Almeida, we are going to see the next person who visited toward the India from the Portuguese side. That person was going to call as the by the name Alfonso Albuquerque. You see, can see after the Almeida who came.
So these Dutch people have started to develop the warehouses in India. The important places we are going to study in India that were developed by the Dutch. So the first place, that is Surat, become the important place for the development of warehouses by the Dutch. After Surat, we are going to see the next place is Bruges. So which is coming near to the Surat itself. So after that, we are going to see the next place, that is Cochin. Then next place we are going to see toward the western side, that is Nagapattinam. Then Visakhapattinam. Then we are going to see the Visakhapattinam. So by this many places they have developed their warehouses. You can take the example of Chinsura, Cambay. These are some important places which they have made the development of warehouses by the Dutch. So after the establishment of these warehouses, they have started their business by storing the goods, and they have broke up the monopoly of the Portuguese sailors. So which goods was sold by the Portuguese? So that Portuguese people have made that goods as the monopoly. That monopoly system was broke by this Dutch, and they have developed their business in India. But anyhow, after the Portuguese who reached to India by the Dutch, they have also ruled in India, but they have failed to continue the trade relations. Why? Because they were unable to control the next Europeans who visited towards India by the name British, or we can say English, and the French company. Because these two companies become very powerful in India after the Dutch, and their business development was totally become declined. By this way, Dutch people have become a weak persons to develop the business. So after knowing this, English and the French, these people have started their journey toward the place, that is Indonesia, and they settled down in Indonesia, and they have started their business, continued toward the European countries from the place of Indonesia. So this is the important point we are going to study in this topic, related to Dutch and the Portuguese. So student, for after this we have studied some point related to the companies visited to the India. Once you get the reading of book from your textbook given to the SSLC board, and after reading you go toward the page number 2, there we are finding the topic related to the know this. By reading this you can get the idea related to the point of what is there in this paragraph. So afterwards you write some questions related to this topic. I will continue the topic in the next class.